Yo, what's up, guys? Tony here, hanging out with you. Can you guys hear me? Quickly let me know if you can see me and if you can hear me. Just want to get some feedback quickly. Let's see if I can check the chat. We are streaming. I can see and hear you, Travis G. Awesome, awesome. Everybody, just type in the chat really quickly where you're shouting in from. And if everything's all good, I know Travis G can hear and see me, type in the chat really quickly. I'm going to start calling some names out, making sure everybody is on board. So we got, Arnold, North Carolina, all good. JW says Kentucky. Morgan Van Dyke says thumbs up. Dana says, hello, Tony from Pennsylvania. Welcome everybody to the live stream today, at Learn Auto Body and Paint. How's everybody doing? It's 3 p.m. here in Hawaii. Aaron Smith says, hey, everyone. Aloha, Tony, joining from Idaho. Morgan from, okay, Morgan, you got me. Kalamazo, I don't know how to pronounce that. So please forgive me. Snowing here in North Carolina. Ooh, yikes. Kansas City in the house. Anthony from Waterford, Virginia. Memphis, Tennessee, joining from Atlanta, Georgia. No problems. Okay, awesome. So we are going to be giving away, hopefully the new VIPs that joined last week are on the call today. We're going to wait till more people jump on in a couple of minutes. Then I'm going to be picking a couple of people here just randomly. For the brand new spray gun that I will buy for you from Zula.com. So we're going to be giving away two brand new spray guns today, $200 value each. That's $400 in equipment. And I hope you guys love it. So if you haven't yet, give a quick thumbs up. And as you guys know, I'm in Hawaii right now, and I don't have any tools here. Like, I'm just starting to buy some tools. Like, I feel like I need some tools now, and I'm just looking on Amazon. Not sure if I can share my screen with you guys. How do I share my screen? I don't know if I can share my screen here. I don't think I could share my screen with the current YouTube platform software here, because I'd show you a bunch of buffers that I'm looking at. Anyway, so what I was thinking of doing, because I'm going back to Texas in about a month or so, and I'm going to bring back some tools. So if I buy another buffer, I'm going to have like all these buffers. So I'm thinking of just donating it to one of you guys once I'm done with it. Tim Lang, VIP from New York, was busy watching another one of your videos. Good thing I got the notice. Awesome, awesome, Tim Lang. Sup, Stephen Mitchell, VIP. Definitely nice to have one of those for sure. Paul, Terry, JW, Home Automation, Home, what? Home Automation, Home for the Future. Wayne from Portadown, Northern Ireland. Cool, guys. Pistol Pete's in the house. Awesome. So, guys, let's see how we're going to be doing this. It looks like I'm getting a lot more chats coming in this live chat. There's no way for me to share my screen because I wanted to show you the buffers that I'm looking at. Another giveaway idea would be a VIP to Learn Auto Body. That's an awesome idea, and we've done that many times, Arnold, and I do plan on doing more. Ponder, Texas. I know where that is. Awesome, guys. Okay, so in the chat room here, who joined in the last week where we did a lifetime membership sale for Learn Auto Body VIP? Type in the chat if you're a brand new VIP member. Just type it in. Just say, I'm here to learn because blah, blah, blah. And just put new VIP. New VIP, I'm here to learn because blah, blah, blah. And then we'll see what's going on. I might pick one of you guys through the chat here, and then another one just through randomly through the new VIP email list that we got. You know what I mean? Like through our actual buyer list. Okay, so Dennis says, I am a new VIP. I sent out an email notification, so we should have more people coming on. Congratulations, Dennis, still waiting to get my funds to join. Paul says, a month ago, I've not been one very long. Bill D, I'm a new VIP. Anybody else? Like, did you guys, Bill and Dennis, did you join like last week when we were doing the lifetime sale? New to the live chat. What's up, Terry Fields? Congrats, Bill. Anthony Lane, new VIP. Okay, so the qualifications are you guys have to be a brand new VIP that joined last week. Last week. Okay. And normally I would ask an auto body question, and whoever gets it right would win a new product or a spray gun or a cleaning kit or spray pearls or flakes or whatever. Right. But you guys are so new, I would kind of hate to ask you a technical auto body question and you're like, you kind of don't know the answers. Right. So let's just say, Dennis, you're the first one to answer. You won a brand new spray gun. How's that? You won, Dennis, my man. From Ponder, Texas, Dennis, I am buying you a Atom Mini X16 spray gun. Don't worry, you other VIPs, you're going to have more chances to win stuff. So don't sweat it. All right, everybody has a chance. And we're going to be doing tons of more of these. So Dennis, you got it. You were the first one to say something live. So congratulations. All you have to do, Dennis, is email ninjasupport@learnautobodyandpaint.com and tell them I won the free Mini X16 Atom spray gun. Comes with a cup, of course. It comes with the regulator, the gun, and a little brush and a wrench to do that. So you're getting this stuff right here, dude. And to be to give you a technical breakdown of the gun that you just won, I will give you a link so you can check it out after the call today. So you can see and get excited and using your new gun. I like the X16 a lot. It's a really good gun. So congratulations on that. Yo, yo, yo. So there is the gun you won. Congratulations. Okay, Stephen Bear. I'm a new VIP lifetime member. Just joined a couple days ago. Already been through the first three lessons. Steve. What's up, Steve? How are you liking the program so far? There's a lot of content and a lot of new content coming up very, very soon as well. So let's get into about 10 minutes of auto body Q&A. If you guys have some questions, let me know. And if you haven't liked yet, don't forget to give a little like over here in the stream. So somebody asked me earlier, what am I doing in Hawaii? Well, I'm moving back. I actually left Hawaii in 2013. I bought a house in Dallas. I had my shop up there, home up there. So I rented that out. My wife, you know, my mom wanted to sell her house. So I'm like, well, what are you going to do? Where are you going to live once you sell the house? Because we have a pretty big house here in Hawaii. So she's like, I don't know. I want to downsize. It's too much maintenance for me, blah, blah, blah. So I'm like, what if I bought the house? So I ended up buying the house from my family, and we just closed on it in late December. So I'm kind of moving back my family to Hawaii. You can't beat the weather here. It's great. We can do body work and painting all year long. And it's just awesome. So I'm really excited to move him back. My homie Tony just got a new body shop. I was taking videos the other day of us moving into the new body shop. He says, Tony, anytime you need to work on anything, you got to come down. No problem. I hooked up with some of my old Samoan friends, Mr. Junior, Samoan dude, got his own body shop downtown as well. So we're going to be doing videos of all like the body shop behind the scenes. Would you guys be excited to see some of the behind the scenes of other body shops and how they do body work? You know, like I'll be there like videoing their work, their projects. I'll be there in the booth with them. I'll be painting, of course. I have this CRV project that we're going to be painting within the next couple weeks. I'm just waiting for the shop set up. We got a blow up spray booth that we're going to be installing. I'm going to be videoing all of that. We're putting in a frame machine. So that's coming. So it's going to take a couple weeks for the shop to be ready. The compressor is coming in today. So I'll be down there tomorrow taking more footage with my camera. And I've been taking footage. It's just, I don't want to release like just 5 minutes of, hey, here's the new shop. You know, I want to actually put together a little mini series of all of what's going on. So it's going to be, hey, here's the new shop. Hey, we're blowing up the new blow up spray booth. You know, check that out. And that could be like something you guys can watch and enjoy and check out. So that's what I plan on doing here. So, you know, it seems like, yeah, you're in Hawaii, Tony, living the life, but I am actually behind the scenes planning out some content for you guys and for you VIP guys. So it's going to be very, very fun. Also, Stephen Mitchell, great comment. Also, another thing, I plan on doing a flip. So there's a 2003 Honda CRV that I'm kind of rolling around in right now. It's a pretty beat up car. It's a flip that I did months ago. What's up, Jean-Paul. It's a flip that I did years ago. I don't know if I said a couple months ago, but years ago, like 9 years ago. And I ended up buying it back for $1,200. So it needed a complete detail. We have footage of all of that already done. Actually, one video is going to be releasing today after the stream. So after the stream, keep an eye out. It's like ready to push live. You're going to get a notification for a new video that is going to go live where I kind of show you this CRV project that I'm talking about right now. You get to see the game plan of the paint job project we're going to do on it. You're going to see the dirty interior. And then the second video is going to be basically pressure washing the interior down. You're like, how are you going to do that, Tony? Well, I took out the seats, pressure washed it. It was nasty. It was like ugly, bad, stink, fish oil, nasty. So you're going to be able to see that stuff as well. All right. So let me come up here quickly, guys, and answer some questions. Again, congratulations, Dennis, winning the spray gun there. Steven, don't worry. You're going to have a chance. Paul says, your VIP program is very cool. How do you prep a panel that someone plasti-dipped? Okay, Arnold. So if somebody plasti-dipped the panel, hopefully they did not sand it. Because when you plasti-dip, ideally, you're painting over a glossy surface. So if you don't like it, you can just peel it off. So try that. Try peeling a section and then peeling the plasti-dip off. Okay? Because you need to get that off. There's no way you're going to be painting on top of that, or prepping and painting on top of the plasti-dip. You got to peel number one, you got to take that off, and then you would prep it the way regular auto body is prepped, right? And ready for paint. So hopefully this helps. I love the program. Been about 20 years since I painted a 69 Volvo, Steven says. P1800S. That is a cool looking car with acrylic enamel. Just trying to upgrade the old skills. That is awesome. Stephen Bear, I think you're going to love our trainings, and we're here for you if you have any questions. What is the best way to get a little rust off a 1947 Plymouth Deluxe? So if you have like little rust spots, I would just get a grinder, grind it off. If you have a hole, you might want to sheet metal spot weld it. But before doing that, you'd want to use like a vinegar water or a navel jelly to just kill the rust. Okay, just put it on there, kill it. Then you would scuff it. Okay, after you let it dry for 30 minutes or so, you would scuff it. Then you could put your body filler over it. If it's just a little surface rust, you could even put a little etch primer on it if you want. You know, make it thick, and then you can scuff it flat with a little block and then put some 2K primer over that. Then you're pretty much ready for paint. You know, it all depends on how bad the rust is, okay? Any suggestions for a cheap paint booth? Well, you can try one of those blow-ups, but they're pretty costly. I think they're like $2,000 for the decent ones. The one we're getting is a used one, and we're getting it for about $1,000. Not too bad. But you're going to see the video of us like putting it together, blowing it up and all that. It's going to be pretty neat. I'm thinking of opening a little 1-2 bay garage. That's awesome, Steve. Do it. Okay, let's see. Let us know how the blow up works. Well, Aaron, I'm going to be documenting the whole thing, so you'll be able to see it. Okay. Hey, Tony, got some new gray 2K primer on a fiberglass fender. After sanding, I got back down to the white gel coat in sections. Can I base over this? Start. Yes, you can base over it, but I would make sure you have primer over your gel coat. Okay, don't base. I wouldn't base over your gel coat. Okay, put some more primer on it. Put a couple of coats on it. Get it thick. Sand it down, and then you should be good to go. Steven says, I saw a comparison video on the YouTube between $700 the Valbus and an Atom X 20 where he was trying to show a difference in finish. It was an epic fail. Not possible to see a difference. Dang, if that's their car, can you imagine their house? What happened to 8 Central time? It's 8 p.m. Eastern time. Well, it was 8 p.m. Central time. It's 8 p.m. Eastern time. Well, we can flip back and forth. If you guys want to go later, we can do this a little later. I'm just, you know, kind of didn't want to make it too late for you guys. You know what I mean? So let me know if this is a good time for you guys or if you guys prefer another time. Again, we're going to be doing these weekly so I can switch it up. I can do, you know, 8 p.m. Central 1 week, 9 p.m. Central another week. You know, it all depends. I'm here for you. We're going to be doing these every single week. Can I Bondo over primer? Yes, absolutely, Raj. You can Bondo over primer, but make sure your primer is scuffed up to like 80 grit. Like get the area scuffed up, then you can prime on top of that and then block it out. JW says, anyone not a VIP should be. Okay, so talking about VIP quickly, guys. We had a handful of people, more than a handful of people, about 10, 11 emails came in saying, Tony, I want to become a VIP, but I just can't afford the $97 lifetime membership at this point. Do you have a payment option? Is there something else you can do? Well, you know, that's been like the best deal ever, $97 for a lifetime membership. There's like over 170 hours of step-by-step videos in VIP. Plus, you get entered into the VIP club, which basically you can win cool free stuff. You know, I have to charge something for VIP to keep doing this kind of stuff. So I said, why not? I told my team to create a 5-pay option plan. So I'm going to put that here, guys. It's only going to be open for 24 hours. If you want to join VIP, it's $19.95 for 5 months. I mean, dude, that's a killer deal. So check on it. It's only going to be up for 24 hours. I didn't even tell the rest of my subscribers yet. But you guys are the ones that are on right now, so you get that opportunity to jump in at $19.95 right now if you wanted to. What else? Okay, so we have okay, hold on, guys. I just got to kind of scroll up here. Okay. Clint, I see you, Clint. What's up, Tony? Richie, someone said La Fotane. Mercia Motors. Hey, Tony, doing body work and repainting my 2011 Silverado extended cab. I'll be painting it Viper blue, which is a metallic. I'm not spraying primer over the entire truck. Is TPC a good base paint? I don't know from experience, but I've heard that it's a okay product. I heard that it's okay. So I don't know. You could just try it. You know, I go with Sherman Williams, DuPont, PPG. That's kind of like the paints that I use. Omni if I want to go cheaper. But yeah, hopefully that helps. I would just try it. Don't be afraid to try new products, guys. Don't be afraid. Just try it out. I mean, it can't be that bad. You know what I mean? TPC Global is a pretty good company. I mean, they've been around. You could even try Eastwood products. I've never painted with Eastwood, but I've heard pretty good reviews on it. So yeah, Travis says, I see you're offering VIP for free for a week. Yes, that offer is actually coming down. We're not going to be doing that anymore. So yeah. How to prep and paint a Pontiac Trans Am bumper. It's the same thing, Charlie. It's a plastic bumper. I believe it's a plastic bumper. You would just sand it down with 400 grit, and that's a perfect tooth, you know, grit. 400 grit to do base coat and clear coat over. All right. The panels were aftermarket fenders and good, you know how they come back in color and they were never painted. It got surface rust and they plasti-dipped it. Now they want to paint it. Oh, so Arnold's talking about that. How would you prep and paint plasti-dip? Aftermarket fenders, good. They came back black and they never painted it. It got surface rust and they plasti-dipped it. So yeah, Arnold, I would just try to peel it off. Peel it off. If you can't peel it off, you'd have to get some like 150 grit and sand it off and then lay two coats of 2K filler primer on it and then wash it down with 400, get it flat, and then you're good for paint. Jean-Paul said, about to start a project on a Ford Expo 400 grit on rough parts. 150 grit wet by hand, 1500 grit for the color sand and buff, just making sure. Well, 400 grit is like grit you want to be painting over. And I wouldn't be doing wet sand with 150 grit. You'd want a wet sand. You have it kind of opposite. 150 grit is good for shaping body filler. 80 grit, 150 grit. And then you would 2K prime over that. After that, you would check for imperfections. Maybe use a little bit of spot putty glaze to fill in some chips or pinholes or whatever if you have any. And then you would wash that down with 400 grit, blocking it, ready for paint. Okay, and of course you'd want to reprime over any glaze putty or bare body filler areas before you paint it. Okay, and then scuff that down again. Just got my tax return money. Going to start flipping with that tax money and see where I end up. So that's what I'm doing actually. So I got this Honda CRV for $1,200. I'm going to probably put $300 into it. I put some new floor mats in like today, and I think I'm going to flip it for around. I'm going to start at $4,250. I'll be happy if I get 38, 39, $4,000 for it. I know I should get $4,000 for it. It's clean, runs great, 125,000 miles, and it's going to have a brand new paint job on it because we're going to paint it. And the paint job alone is going to be a $2,000 value. So they're going to be getting something really nice. Arnold says, this time works perfect for me. Great time. Eastern is fine. Just got on late. Have you have any videos on painting ghost stripes? How do you do it? It's the same process. You just have to mask up for the flames and then use a mini gun and do like your ghost dusting. So ghost stripes are basically just dusting your flames in on the corners and then taking unmasking. Then you have like a ghost. You could even go very light, like put like a pearl in your clear coat or inner coat to give it that ghost look. It's all you're doing is putting a very, very thin atomized layer of paint instead of full on paint when you're doing graphics. That's what ghosting is. So it's pretty easy to do. I will do more of that type of stuff once I get set back up in my new shop. Hey, Tony, VIP from the UK, and I love it. Awesome. Hold on. I just lost where I was. TCB Global is legit, somebody said. Pistol Pete said, 97 is well worth it. Lifetime can't beat it. And all that you do for free. Thank you, Pistol Pete. Can I share my VIP with my son? Absolutely. Why not? Either time works for me, Stephen Mitchell. Extremely reasonable deal. How many VIP members do you have now, Tony? Well, we've been doing this since 2010. We probably have like 13,500 VIP members. But you got to remember, not everybody's on YouTube, right? Not everybody's on Facebook. And this is over 10 years. So there's probably thousands that probably never logged back in from back in the years. You know what I mean? So we have about a good 5,000 or 6,000 active who are actively opening emails and all that stuff. So, having trouble with bad orange peel with single stage urethane, any tips for future use? Well, I would make sure maybe you could reduce your mixture by 5%, adding a little bit more reducer to it, getting it a little thinner and upping your pressure on your spray gun. And, you know, it also depends what PSI you're spraying at. So with single stage, you don't want to be spraying too high, you know, 27, 28 pounds trigger pulled is usually a good. And when you're spraying it on, you know, make sure when you're spraying, it's laying on glossy. Okay. Make sure it's laying on glossy. Several years ago, I sanded not to bare metal, original paint, and a couple of layers of single stage metallic state blue, and it's getting about due to paint again. Should I sand all the way back down? Morgan, it depends on the project. If this is something you're going to keep and you really want a nice paint job on it, you could sand it off and kind of start fresh. But if it's something that you really don't care about, you're going to sell soon or whatever, you could just scuff it, sand it, paint it, and do what you got to do with it. It's really what you want to do. Letty says, oh my God, I learned so much on how to paint because of you. And my motor said, thank you, but I'm still having trouble getting the perfect spray setting on a Harbor Freight $15 gun. Well, I've sprayed with those $20 guns on Harbor Freight before. You know, they're okay. They'll last a shot or two, but they're not made for use over and over again, you know? So I would consider using a medium grade gun, you know, and if you want to get something medium grade, look at Finish Line or Atom X, really good spray guns. I would actually look into the Atom X 20 spray gun. I've used epoxy primer, ceramic, chassis paint. Both are good. Jay Demio says. Kevin Walker, second time on live, coming in from Louisiana. I used Nason to paint my F-150 and was pleased with it and wasn't that pricey. Yeah, Nason's a pretty good brand as well. It's a cheaper brand of DuPont. Sherman Williams is the best paint for me. So I've been talking to my paint buddy and he's telling me he's been using a lot of Sherman Williams, and I'm actually going to be using a Sherman Williams clear coat on the CRV. So I'll tell you how I like that. Okay. So let's get caught up here again, guys. If you want to join VIP, the special pricing, there's a $19.95. You can get started right now if you want to do that. The Aviation Network, Letty, on the 2X, use the Harbor Freight guns for primer only. I agree. You can use that for primer. Get the Atom X, Atom, and Mini. I got both, and you will paint like a pro. They are Japanese-made quality. It's awesome. VIP videos talk about Dana Weld epoxy adhesive, but you can't buy that anymore. What's a good replacement? Okay, so I do, Jay Demio, I have updated videos in VIP of the new stuff that I'm using. Check out the Miata project. It's the 3M body bonding adhesive. I don't know the number offhand, but if you look at the Mazda Miata project, it's in that series because that's what I used. It's the 3M panel bonding adhesive. I think it's zero. DeMeo. All right, DeMeo. So yeah, check that out. Can you go ahead painting base coat after dry sanding fried base coat? Thanks. Yes. What do you exactly mean fried base coat? Like base coat that you painted and left for a couple days, or I don't get it. Can you go ahead painting base coat after Jack Jocko from the Philippines? I have a 26-gallon Quincy compressor and want to add a second tank as a reserve tank. Can I use the high volume, low pressure with that setup? Yes, I would think so. It depends how much CFM your compressor puts out. I mean, if it's a pretty much good amount and you're adding another tank to it, you'll have more reserve, more volume that you can use. But once you use that volume up, your compressor is going to have to fill all of that back up. And if it can't fill it as fast as you're using it, you're going to have to kind of play the waiting game. And you can do it. I mean, I've painted a complete car with a 30-gallon Craftsman compressor. You just have to know how to flow it. You know what I mean? And go around the car and time it well. Like, you don't want to be taking a break in the middle of clear coating your hood. You want to make sure you kind of got enough pressure to finish that hood. You know what I mean? I want to buy Eastwood Turbines paint system. Do know if worth buy? I don't know. And you know what? I might actually get one of those systems just to do a review for you guys and see how that stuff works. Chopping the top on a 71 Buick Riviera. Cool, that's a nice looking car. Harbor Freight is for sealer and primer only. You sand it anyway. Yep, Adam for all base coat and clear coat. I agree. Have you ever tried 3M paint gun? I do have it at home in Texas, and I do plan on bringing it back. How does the cup system work? Should take my car to Mako or just try and paint it myself? It depends, man, on what you want to do. So the quick cup system or the paint cup system basically works by you just take off your main cup. You put an adapter like this on it, which is sold at Zula.com for all regular spray guns. And then this one is for the mini spray gun, especially for the X16 model here. So you just put this on like this. And then when you order your quick cup system, if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, let me actually show you what I'm talking about. Quick cup system. So, and it has links on this website where you could see the adapters that you want. Are you guys getting that link? Let me know if you guys are getting that link. So your paint cup system, you can get a 850 milliliter cup. You can get a 400 and you can get a 650 milliliter cup. So that's basically, it just screws right on. And then you basically would put it on upside down. So you would have your paint cup, your liner, right? And then you could mix your base coat right in there. And then you would just cap it, close the cap, and then put it right on to the top of your gun. And then you're, that's basically it. And if you have leftover base coat, there's actually a plug where you can plug that liner and you can keep that. Clear coat you can't keep because it's going to cure, right? But base coat you can keep. Yep, we all see the link. Okay, so that's the quick cup system, guys. It can go on any spray gun. It doesn't have to be Adam X spray guns. It could be on any spray gun. And there's two different adapters. One adapter for the mini spray guns, which is this one I have on here, because this is a mini X16. It's not a huge gun, right? It's a pretty small gun. Good for door jams, motorcycle tanks, and whatnot. And then the standard size spray gun. I have my other spray gun over there, but there's a bigger size, okay, adapter. The support is ninjasupport@learnautobodyandpaint.com. Thank you, Tim Lang. I just showed it, Tim Lang. I just approved it so that link can show for Dennis. Is it worth to pay $240 to use a spray booth or use my garage with a 20-gallon compressor spray? I would just pay try to bargain them down to like $175. $240 is a lot of money, man. Because I could rent a spray booth here for $150. It used to be $100, but now they're charging about $150. So that's the going rate. $150, I mean, maybe $200, but $240 seems kind of crazy. But to ensure that your car is going to be in a ventilated booth where you're not going to have any issues, you're going to have the proper air because the air compressor comes with the booth, right? They're going to supply you because there's air in the booth. It might be something that you'd want to consider, you know, but I would kind of bargain down, man. Tell them like, come on, man, do it for $175. You'll be out of there in 6 hours. Yeah, cup systems do save a lot of time. Can a regular single phase compressor work for painting a car in your garage? Yes, it can. It can. But I would rather a two-stage air compressor. You get a little bit more CFM building up quicker. And it's good at least to have a 60-gallon tank if you're doing some DIY stuff. This way you could actually paint a full car in your garage or your mini shop with no issues. Tim Lang says, Tony, any update on your daughter in Japan? Send her and your wife some love from your VIPs. Thank you so much, Tim Lang. And I will do that. And I'm actually going to be getting on a call with my wife soon. She's moving back to Hawaii. I got to go pick her up in July. So we still are months away, but I'm going to be getting them very soon. I'm here with my 11-year-old daughter, Maya. Charlie says, is there a difference between the X20 and X21 spray gun? There is, and actually the X21 was replaced with the X27. So this is the X27 spray gun here. I just like to show everybody what I'm talking about because it just helps you guys. So the X20 and the X27, the X20 is more of an entry level and the X27 is more of like a professional spray gun. But all spray guns at Zula.com come with the new Gun Bud Ultra Lighting System, which is really cool. It's kind of like a more inexpensive, affordable version of the Lumalai. You guys ever see those spray guns with the lights coming out on the side? They charge like $200 for that thing. I thought that was kind of crazy, but the gun butt goes on your cup system and it's adjustable. It goes on any cup, universals. It doesn't, you know what I mean? You could put that on any spray gun you want, even your cheap Harbor Freight $20 gun. And if you guys don't know what I'm talking about this thing here, the gun butt. If you play the video, you can see kind of like what it does. Here. But anyway, congratulations, Dennis, on winning the spray gun. We are going to give the other one away by email. All right. We're going to pick one of your, how many new VIPs on? Let's just do another one right now. How many brand new VIPs on right now who joined within the last week at our $97 special? Let's just see. Maybe I'll just pick another one of our new VIPs from here. A new VIP. What is the difference of an oven dry between coats? Benefit of an oven dry. There's no real benefit. It's just you're just getting the job done quicker. Tony, we are still doing this right. Doing what? Mako, basic paint job. I mean, it's up to you. Hamong, American Life. If you want to tackle a paint job yourself, do it. If you feel like you don't want to be bothered, you want to just pay somebody, take it to Mako. But Mako, they really don't do great paint jobs, so don't expect anything really nice. Hi, Tony. Can you get a chameleon effect if you mix different color pearl powders together? Yes, you can, but it won't be like the true chameleon. Just keep that in mind. I'm doing this repair on a 2011 Ford Mustang, race red, fixing door and quarter panel in front of tire. Should I just paint the whole quarter panel or blend it at least 1 foot square? I would do the whole quarter panel. This way you get a nice solid clear coat on that job. Just finish it. Don't even bother blending it. Just clear down the whole. You would blend the base coat and clear the entire panel and then buff the adjacent panels when you're done. This way you'd have like a professional paint job and it'd be done. Guys, if you haven't yet, do a quick like. If you haven't yet, we got about 60 people on the call. I'm going to call it quits very soon. We're going to wrap it up in the next couple of minutes after I pick a new VIP winner for our spray gun. Where do I join? Sexto says he's new, but now he's like, where do I join? How do I join? So guys, we're doing a 24-hour special right now. You can get in at $19.95. That's the wrong link. Here's the correct link. And this is because people wanted a pay plan. So we are doing a 5 pay plan of $19.95 if you want to do that. It doesn't look like we have that many new people. And I know it's because of just the time difference. So many people are from all parts of the world and maybe this time just didn't work out for some of you guys, but that's why we're going to be doing these weekly. Chris Brooks, are you new VIP? Where are you located, Chris Brooks? And what are you working on? Here's the link again, guys. It's only good for 24 hours. So, Chris Brooks, you got my attention. Talk to me, buddy. Talk to me. Mount Home, Idaho. What are you working on, Chris? Tell me a little bit about yourself. Quick. There are new YouTube videos on the turbines and review. I would recommend investing in a good two-stage 60-80 gallon compressor instead. You'll need it for DA and your air tools. That's true. Guys, it's always nice to have a real air compressor. You know, some guys are out there using the turbines. It's all good. But if you have a real air compressor, like, your problems are solved, because you could do all the, you could use all the pneumatic tools you want, DAs, you know, blowing air, sanders, spray guns, anything, you know, impact wrenches, like mechanic stuff as well. You could use it for everything, and you're not going to be left hanging. So I would definitely invest in a good 60 gallon minimum compressor with a 5 horsepower minimum, and just go from there. Okay, so Chris Brooks said he's retired Air Force working on a 1970 F-250. Sweet. Okay, guys, well, the pub Learn Auto Body is what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's something I got to look back into. Okay, guys, we are just going to get it over with right now. And we are going to gift Mr. Chris Brooks, retired Air Force. Thank you for your service to this country. You're retired. You're working on that beautiful 1970 Ford 250, great American truck. We're going to give you a brand new, I am buying you a brand new Atom X16 spray gun. Congratulations. Welcome to the club, Chris Brooks. There you go. So all you have to do, Chris, is just email ninjasupport@learnautobodyandpaint.com, and I will buy you the Mini X16 spray gun and send it over to your house this week. Okay, and here is the book, not the book, the link to what you're getting, just so you know what you're getting. So email ninjasupport@learnautobodyandpaint.com and tell them you won Tony's X16 spray gun giveaway as a new VIP member, and give them your shipping address so we can get that over to you. All right, guys, thank you so much for getting on. We gave away 2 spray guns today, $400, over $400 with shipping. It's like $450 value. Thank you so much for joining us. We're going to be on next week, and stay tuned. Within the next 10 minutes, I am going to release a brand new video right now of the CRV project. Here is Lonnie.
We adopted her from the Humane Society. She's 7 months old. Oh my
God. She's 7 months old. We got a beautiful chihuahua. She's so sweet, guys. I never liked little dogs until this one. Like, I grew up with German shepherds and huge dogs, but this one is so cute. I love her. She is the best. We sleep with her.
Yeah, we do.
Here. Anyway, guys. That's a rat dog. That's what I call her. I call her the rat. So it was so funny. Hello, hello. Because I was in the bathroom peeing the other day, and I didn't know she was in the shower. So I was peeing, and like at the corner of my eye, I see this thing like run out from the shower, and I thought it was a rat. I was like, oh my God. And I like ended up peeing on parts of the toilet as well. And I was like, oh my God. It was ridiculous. Like, Maya heard me from the other end of the house, right?
Yeah.
It was hilarious.
I'm like, did she make a mistake and did he step on a poop or something? I was like, oh, no.
Oh, God. Anyway, guys, thanks. It was great seeing everybody on. Hit the thumbs up before you leave. And welcome new VIP members. See you on next week. And for all of you non-VIP guys, again, we have this special that's going to come down in 24 hours. You could join at $19.95. It's a 5-payment plan for over 5 months, and you're VIP for life. You get access to 170 hours of step-by-step auto body videos, the Facebook group, the YouTube lives, chances to win all kinds of cool stuff, and everything in between. Thank you, guys. See you on next week. Stay tuned in the next 10 minutes. We got a new video coming out right now in 10 minutes. Cheers.